Celestial greetings, family members, friends, members of the global community. My name is Celeste Bateman, and I want to tell you about a project that I'm working on. It's a documentary film called Gone Too Soon. Gone Too Soon is about the life, the legacy, and the loss of several icons from my community, Newark, New Jersey, who gave of their talents and creativity and left behind a treasure trove of gifts that benefit our community. We're going to examine a 15-year period. Some of the people that we want to examine are Rodney Gilbert, who was a theater professional. He also headed our mural project in the city of Newark, but he was a wonder for young people who were interested in involving themselves in playwriting and acting. And he left a huge gap when he passed on not too many years ago. Jerry Gant was a visual artist, a sculptor, a painter, designed clothing, wearable art, and he left us much too soon. We want to chronicle his life. Alida Caldwell was the principal of Arts High School, which is the oldest performing arts high school in the country. She left a legacy and a trail of outstanding students who grew up under her tutelage and are now successful artists in the global community. There are many others. Dr. Clement Alexander Price, who headed up the history department at Rutgers Newark University for many, many years, and who formed an institute which today is named after him. Dr. Robert Kirvin, who also documented the history of the city of Newark, left us much, much too soon, and there are many others. Some of the others we want to feature in this documentary are Bria Blackberry Molasses Knight. She was an extraordinary poet, an extraordinary sensitive, who gave of her verbal talents whenever asked. Another person we want to recognize is Cephas Bowles, who was the first African-American to head up our jazz radio station, WBGO Jazz 88. We want to talk about all of the contributions that came to the city under his watch as the CEO of WBGO, a world-renowned jazz radio station. We also want to discuss Charles Cummings, who chronicled the history of Newark, New Jersey in a series of articles for the Star Ledger, and for whom the New Jersey Room at the Newark Public Library has been renamed. And we cannot forget activist, poet, playwright, Amiri Baraka, with whom I had the pleasure of working for a number of years as his agent and publicist. Amiri left us much too soon. I think it is important to document this legacy because we have so many new people in our community as the city of Newark grows. We have an influx of new employees. We have outstanding new, young, vibrant artists, painters, muralists, performers of all kinds, and an influx of new residents. And none of these people, or many of these people, do not know about these people that I want to feature in this documentary because they passed on before they got here. I think it is important to document this history so that they know. And it is important for students to know about the cultural contributions that these icons, as I call them, have given to our community. And I hope that this documentary will be an inspiration to others in other similar communities across the country to do likewise, to focus on the people who have made so many outstanding contributions to their individual communities, perhaps before they die. So I'm appealing to you today to please support this GoFundMe initiative. It doesn't matter if it's $5 or if it's $500. We appreciate your support. And for those of you who are able to give $100 or more, we will mention you in the credits of the film. Thank you so much in advance. Celestial greetings.